In my hands is a Huawei mobile phone, and its problem is that when the charger is connected, it must be constantly correct. Charging doesn't always work, and fast charging is not work. Here install the Type-C connector. The client has already bought two boards. The first had no fast charging, and the second burned out a day later. I remove the Type-C connector from the burned out board, and now we will change it. I quickly disassemble the phone and remove the board. See how the boards differ from each other. You can put it in pause. In Chinese board there are no many elements, microphones and antennas. Therefore, we'll rearrange new connector on the original board. Elements that can burn out because of temperature are connectors and microphones. High temperatures may cause microphones to stop working. We tape it with heat resistant Kapton tape. Further on the connector, here is the compound. Before removing the connector, be sure to remove the compound from it and all the elements nearby. Set the temperature of the dryer to about 120 degrees and like this carefully remove the compound with a toothpick. After removing it, take the flux. I use the usual Chinese RMA223. I have it in a syringe and apply flux to the connector. Set the temperature to 280 degrees, blowing about 40%. And gradually warm up the board first and then the connector. Try to remove it without effort. Don't tear it when the solder heats up. It will gently peel off by itself. It's so easy. But if you are in a hurry, you can tear out all the interface contacts. This is how the connector looks like. Next, take isopropyl alcohol or flux remover and remove all the old burned out flux. After that, apply a new one. Take the braid for desoldering and remove all the old heat-resistant solder in this way. It is easy to do this from the interface contacts. The main thing, not to overheat them and not rip them off the board. But the fixing holes are a little more complicated. The solder goes away harder. The main thing here is patience and more flux and heat it longer. After this procedure, again clean everything with alcohol. And this is how the board should look like new, but only without a connector. Next, take solder on the tip and transfer it to the interface contacts. Make such pads. If the solders stick together, add a little more flux and warm it up better. All contacts should look neat and the same. Buy in different shops with savings up to 30%. The cashback service letyshops.com. More than 2 million users are already saving with us. Join to Letyshops. Links in description. Then take a new connector and put it in its place. take a hair dryer, set the temperature as we removed it, and warm it up again. When the solder has melted, it is not spoiled by its gloss. Carefully adjust the connector and center it over the interface pins. Leave to dry. As you can see, all the legs are already soldered. This can be checked by trying to bend them with tweezers. But still, this is not enough. Then we resolder it. Now we solder the main legs of the connector, add more flux, and transfer the solder to the legs. They already need to be warmed up for soldering a little more. There are such elements as this antenna that interferes. Just remove it and then put it back. Now add flux to the interface contacts and solder them. Take a little solder on the tip and warm each contact by pressing it a little. After soldering, let it cool down and clean the connector to check the soldering. This is how it looks. It can be seen, and so everything was soldered efficiently. But I still always double check all the legs with tweezers. If everything is good, remove the tape and clean the entire board from the flux. Only again with microphones. Don't pour alcohol into them, as it may also stop working. On the microphone, just gently clean with an almost dry brush. Clear the board, connect it back to the phone, connect all the cables back, insert the charging connector. It snapped into place perfectly, and charging went without any corrections. And on the USB tester, see 2 amperes, which is quite satisfactory. Fast charging also turns on and works great. That's all. Replace the Type-C connector was successful. Did the video help, or just you like it? Put like. And also don't forget to watch my other videos and click on the circle in the center of the screen and subscribe to the Art Bell channel.